So today I'm at Dar-es-Salaam, Tanzania, flow farm site with my friend here. He's called Lawrence. Yeah, area ya Kibamba. Yeah, so he's going to explain to us what he's doing here with vegetables.
Okay.
Yeah, so
you are welcome.
Okay, thank you.
This is our unit for vegetable production.
Okay.
So we can
let's check it out.
Yeah. And here we have different systems for growing vegetables.
Okay.
And this system based on urban farming, but they can be done also in a larger scale.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Like
so this is Chinese cabbage?
This is a Chinese cabbage.
What do you call this kind of setup?
This is a bug farming.
Okay.
This is a bug farming.
Okay.
You can grow a large number of vegetables in a single unit.
Okay.
So this system it helps us to utilize the space.
Okay.
It's needed small space for higher production.
Okay, and it seems you have a lot of Chinese cabbage here.
Chinese cabbage.
You mean Tanzania's Tanzanians love Chinese cabbage?
Love Chinese, Chinese eaters.
Okay.
They love so much Chinese.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. This look like hanging gardens.
Yeah, this is a hanging garden of Kibamba.
Okay. Okay.
And here you can grow any vegetable, leafy vegetable. As you see, also we have Chinese cabbage. Also we have different variety of lettuce. Like you see the red lettuce here.
Yeah.
And
red
lettuce. And here is the green lettuce.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is a hanging garden. Also the goal is the same.
Easy. How many stems in each hanging bug?
Of this size, we have 10 stems.
Oh, 10 stems. And how about this? This
here we have 80.
These are 80 stems.
Yeah, 80 heads of
four. Okay. And how big is this bug?
This big diameter is 1 meter.
This
diameter
is 1 meter diameter.
1 meter diameter.
Okay. So in an area of 1 meter, I have 80 stems.
80 stems. And this can do bigger than this.
These hanging bugs are slightly less than a meter.
But our standard units, the bugs have 1.3 meter.
1.3 meters.
1.3 meter.
Okay.
Which can take up to
40 stems. Okay. Okay.
In this system, you can do even your area is flooded.
Okay.
You can practice.
Yeah.
This.
By the way, where we have flooding cases, you can always have hanging gardens.
Yeah.
And I see all this is under a shaded.
Under shed net.
Yeah, on the roof, and also on the sides.
Yes.
Yeah, we have shed net. Okay.
Yes.
I see you have a box.
This we call box garden.
Okay.
This box garden is a
how does it work? Okay.
This is a hydroponic system.
Okay.
We use no soil here.
Okay.
As you see, this is a mixture of peat moss and the sawdust.
Oh, you use peat moss.
Peat moss
and mix it up with sawdust.
Sawdust.
So, what is this?
This is a sawdust before mixed with.
You have not yet mixed.
Not yet mixed.
You get your sawdust from?
Sawdust we get from local workshop.
Okay.
Carpenter's workshop.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the peat moss we buy it from agrovets.
Okay. Yeah. So how do you water it? I can see there's a cloth here.
Yeah.
Okay.
This box we have partitioned it into two parts.
Okay.
We have upper side and lower side.
Okay.
The lower side act as water reservoir.
Okay. So on the okay, that's why you have sealed with this plastic. Okay.
So the water will not leak from the behind.
I see.
Yeah.
From the bottom Okay. Oh, so the plastic goes all the way to the bottom and lines.
Yeah.
And lines the wood.
Yes.
And then now you put your water.
We fill it with the water.
Okay.
After the water reservoir, we have partitioned it.
Mm-hmm.
Then we partitioned it with this cloth.
Okay.
This is the, we call it.
It's like weak a weak
material.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a weak material.
Okay.
Its main function is to absorb that water from reservoir and they suck it up into suck it up to the mixture of sawdust and the peat moss.
Okay.
So you see this moisture here. This moisture here is full from beneath.
Yeah. Okay. So it's like the mixture of peat moss and sawdust is taking up the water through capillarity.
Through capillarity.
And I can see you have some, what are these? They're
this
like
is oxygenation tubes.
Okay, so they are just near plastic
near plastic
that you have put some holes.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Main function of this is to do oxygenation.
Okay.
Oxygen circulation.
Wow. Yeah. This is great. So weak material. Yeah. You know, for our viewers, we should clarify. It's not weak for loss of strength.
It's
W-I-C-K.
W-I-C-K, yeah.
Okay, W-I-C-K.
Yeah. And also beneath on the bottom of our box, we have this tap. This tap is for...
For draining?
When we want to drain, if you put nutrient here, there is a time you need to change that nutrient.
Yeah.
So this is how we drain it.
Okay.
You open it, you drain out the water,
then
you refill the water.
Yeah, you put
fresh
water.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you add any nutrients here?
Basically, we need to add the nutrient.
Yes, yes.
So, because this is hydroponics, it needs hydroponic nutrients.
And farmers can get those nutrients from you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Farmers can get that.
Fair enough. What is this here?
And also, here we have, we call it the home sustainable hydroponic system.
Okay. It's a small, simple setup, you know?
Yeah.
That's okay.
Very simple. Basically, it's for home growers.
Okay, and this one you're just using gravel.
Just gravel.
Okay, no soil.
No soil. At
you're sure if I check down here, I won't find any soil?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
It's a full gravel.
Okay.
So all these plants here are grown on that gravel.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what you're saying is that the water that is in this reservoir has nutrients.
Yes.
Use the gate valve to open. Okay. I know maybe there is little water for now. Okay. So once you open, the water now comes through this. Okay.
I see.
Okay, and
the water is full here. It's good to our.
So there's a drainage area.
There's a drainage tube here.
Okay.
It takes water from our system to our collecting.
So the excess water will drain off at that point.
Exactly.
And then you can reuse the same water.
Yes. If you have, you can install the pump. It's, return the water automatically to the reservoir tank.
Okay. And then
I see
you have this is just a recycled tire. Wow, this is great. Okay. So
we find another usage of the tire.
Okay.
It can be a very good garden.
Okay.
It can give you
This is quite creative, yeah. Okay, so
yeah.
You are doing carrots.
Here we are doing carrots.
Okay.
As you may see.
Let me
this
see.
Is your carrot. It goes very well and nice.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes.
This is a freshly harvested carrot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just from the tire.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I see. So just let me take off the roots.
Also, it's act as decoration to your house.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you can
instead
put
of
it.
Putting flowers, which
you're not eating.
Not eating, and you increase your expenditure by using this.
So this is very good for backyard systems.
Yeah, backyard system.
Wow. Yes. Wow. This is. Wow. It looks like a healthy carrot. Yeah, and. Thanks. You also have another big bag here where you also still
do carrots. This is another big farming, but here we designed it specifically for carrots.
Okay.
Yes. As you see, our carrot is growing very well.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are doing fine.
Okay, that's great. So, we, as Grandia Africa, will ask farmers in Tanzania to visit this farm for more. Lessons.
You get a lot of knowledge here. A lot of system, lot of knowledge, a lot of skills.
Yeah.
Just waiting for them to come.
Okay.
And give them what they want.
Okay. Thank you.
I'm sure they will.
Thank you so much. Okay. So if you are viewing us from anywhere in the world, please subscribe to Grandia Africa. Thank you.